relentless pace of the coronavirus pandemic continues.
The World Health Organization has warned the epicenter of the coronavirus pandemic could shift to the United States.
It's coming every day.
You're hearing all these stories and seeing people dressed up in hazmat suits, and I'm like, oh man. You know, part kind of, it goes out for those people, but of course, if it's like one of your loved ones, you're trying to think of ways that you want to try to keep that person safe.
My sister and I are really close, and I think that as we realized what was happening, she was worried about how I was going to be doing and my well-being. With all of my coworkers, not only like physicians, but nurses, respiratory therapists, everyone in the healthcare profession, I think you feel really vulnerable when you know that you're up against this wave that's going to come.
Everyone's human, right? We're all affected by this virus. And so the need for PPE is universal. I think the really cool silver lining in all of this COVID is that people are really coming together and wanting to help other people out.
Our starting to build face shields began with a request from Hawaii Pacific Health. So they were looking at schools who had 3D printers. They had a design. We began working on it. And then we were approached by members of our ʻIolani ohana. I sent a message to our parents saying that if they're interested, please go online and fill out this form if they wanted a face shield. And that has just ballooned into requests for thousands. So it will be an ʻIolani parent who's the lead at the ER unit at Queens, and they want 150. And it'll be the chief of the Honolulu Fire Department, and they want 1,000.
It's a marathon at sprinting pace is what we're doing here, and we're just trying to get as many as we can out because it's our community. Everyone knows someone in the healthcare system, and it's just great that we're able to provide for them. We knew sourcing materials would be a large problem, not just because we're on this island, but also because there are others, right? There's people are trying to make these too because of the shortage. So we had to design, we had to be creative using the materials that we had on hand and using materials that we know that we'd be able to get more of.
Getting it run by the infection control committee at the hospital was a big step for us. Taylor Wong prepped some of the prototypes for me to take. As soon as they saw what we had been making, they took it straight up to the OR. Within the afternoon, the infection control committee had approved all three designs and we were good to go.
We have this amazing design team and laser cutters. We have 3D printers. When we have the resources and are able to do stuff like this, it's our responsibility. It's a call to action. If you're able to do something in a time of need like this, you should be.
We're all in this together to take care of each other and be as safe as possible. And this is just one little thing, right, that we're able to do that might slow person-to-person transmission for our first-line people. They still need N95 masks. They still need other things. But the one little thing that we can do, we're going to do as much as we possibly can.